Hey there pilots, 3D Hero here, and in today's video I will be talking about how to be effective with Scorch as a Titan main. So let's head straight in and I hope you enjoy. Overall this is going to just be a lowdown of how to be really effective with him and how to control areas using Scorch that may or may not be quite wise to do, such as going up against Tone or Legion. So like I said, I hope you enjoy. To start off, let's look at Scorch main perks. He uses his main T203 Thermite Launcher as his primary. He has a thermal shield that absorbs and does damage to players and Titans. But this only happens if you are up close to, say, a Titan. So if Ronin comes in attacking you, if you use your thermal shield on them, it does damage to them, and it does a pretty good amount of damage. Next, he has Firewall that allows him to whip out a flame wall to damage and block paths. He has incendiary traps, allow him to lay down canisters of gas that explode and cover an area once ignited. And his main special is Flame Claw that sends a pulse wave, or kind of like a mini frontal wave of fire out, and it practically either damages, kill, or destroy anyone that gets in the way. Now, Scorch is ideal for close range and medium fights. This is something you probably know already. To where he'll be able to lay down and suppress fire and stack damage in tight passage areas. Ideally, you want to stack damage on Titans to narrow down their health as quickly as possible. As doing this will allow you breathing room, and depending on the player, they may panic and run for backup. This may allow you two options: to either run after them, or go get backup. But it's really up to you to decide on what you think is effective or not. Just remember that if you are going to chase Scorch, make sure you do kind of have a plan B, as if you don't have the correct perks on you to survive a firefight, it's kind of suicidal. Something I know with Scorch is that he has a good amount of health, but he has no dash ability, unlike the other Titans. So this can be problematic with you getting out of tough situations that require you to back in and back out. Now, I recommend using the +1 dash score to gain the chance of escaping certain situations, and dash to places much quicker compared to before. You're probably thinking it's probably a wasteful perk to use for your Titan, but I honestly recommend that you use it, as in some situations you may get overwhelmed or your team gets overwhelmed and you may be the last survivor. Now, you could probably change the whole tide of the fight if you escape. If you go with something else, but you know what you're doing, that's fine. You don't have to go with the +1 dash core. But if you're new and you kind of want to have a good understanding of how to escape tough situations with Scorch, while being supportive, add a +1 dash core to your Titan and watch how you'll be able to escape certain situations. In some situations, you may get into an issue with Titans coming up close and milling you, like Ronin, who can be a pain if he uses his what's the name of it? It's Sword Core on you. And also, another thing you have to remember is that since your primary weapon reloads slow and fires once at a time, also adding in the fact that your thermite rounds do damage to you makes it highly unlikely for you to survive sometimes. So what I mean by this is that if you ever notice, when you shoot your rounds and you walk into them, or if you shoot your thermal rounds and you basically walk into them, it damages your Titan, and it does take quite a bit of your Titan's health down really quickly if you're not aware. Now, there is a perk that basically narrows down how much damage is taken off you, and you can use that. But by doing that, like I said, you'll be taken off the +1 dash core. So you would really need to think about what is more wiser for you. So in this situation, what do you do? Well, for starters, using your thermal shield can help with absorbing damage and damaging Titans up close, giving you a slight chance to fight back. But that still won't be enough. So that still won't be enough to overall kill or make the Titan back off. If you saved up or you have enough energy ready, you can use a Flame Core that can push back Titans and do enough damage on them to actually make them back away. But this is only viable if you say you have enough energy on you. If you don't have enough energy on you, it leaves you with little to small errors for making you run away. So you can either run away and rethink it, but if you try to run away, they're most likely going to chase you down or shoot you. If you try to fight, it's even more suicidal. So in this situation, kind of think, try to think to yourself, what is more viable and effective? If all options are gone and you think, all right, there's not a chance, what I recommend is that you shoot two canisters up close to you and ignite them. I believe you're allowed to shoot up to two or three canisters. If you ignite them while you're standing in it, it will damage you and it will most likely doom your Titan. But also at the same time, it will also doom the other Titan that's standing in it. Or hopefully it will finish them off. If you're really lucky, you may be able to escape. But if the other Titan minis you before you try to escape, it's too late. They're most likely to get the kill. But at the same time, you'll be able to destroy their Titan. So it may be a win-win in your situation, or maybe a win-loss depending on how you react. So let's talk about the T203 Thermite Launcher. A slow, single-fire AoE launcher that's capable of 1v1 fights against Titans and Pirates alike. To master such a weapon, you need to know how to effectively aim. Now, you're probably sitting there thinking, aim? Why would I need to effectively know how to aim? Everyone knows how to aim, you idiot. But hear me out first. Sounds stupid, I know, but this weapon requires you to aim above target for much longer distances. So, say if a team's not pushing up. For a good example, Black Canal. I believe that's the name of the map. Where there's a bridge in the middle. Usually, if there's Titans appearing, usually both sides won't advance because they know it's suicidal if they try to push up. So what they tend to do is they tend to sit back and take pot shots at each other. And this goes back and forth. So for someone maining Scorch, you're probably going to be thinking, how can I be effective? Well, thing is, you're going to need to learn how to effectively aim above the target. And when I mean above, I mean moving your main weapon's vectile, say above the target's head. It's a lot of practice you need to do to actually formally get the shot. It's not an easy, I would say it's not really easy to adjust and get used to, but once you get the hang of it, you'll be taking out people from long distances. So people like Legion or Tone or Ion or Ronin and such that like to stay back and they're taking pot shots at you, you'll have an easy time with them. Once you learn how to shoot overhead, and if you also land a direct hit onto their critical spot, you're doing a ton of damage to them. So just remember that. So the best place I recommend personally to adjust your aim is game modes like Bounty Hunter and Attraction to practice in less skilled environments. Also for a Titan like Scorch, who's slow and can take out a lot of damage if not prepared, cover is your ideal friend since it will cover you for your slow reload and allow you to either bait or do pot shots. So like I said, ideally if you go into game modes like Bounty Hunter or Attraction, so Attraction is basically TDM, if you go into these game modes here, and depending on the maps, you want to learn how to take out Titans from a long distance. But while you're doing that, you also want to learn the weakness of your main Titan. Your main weakness of your Titan is that he's slow, that can be fixed. And he reloads slow, that can't be fixed. So how to be effective, Scorch? Simple. Make sure you have cover near you. Don't go out on the wide open, as going out on the wide open with Scorch is 100% risky, especially against Tone or Legion. Unless you got people to back you up, I recommend that you don't push ahead. It's suicidal. If you don't want to push up, better off support your team. Lay down canisters of fire. If Ronin is making a move and he's trying to get in close, make sure you try to bait him out. Try to shoot in areas that you think he's gonna go into. Try to predict your enemy's movements. The more you learn how to counter certain Titans, the more easy it will be. I found that, you know, at first Legion and Tone and Ronin used to be a problem, but once you understand how they move and how they act, they're practically easy, just like all Titans. All Titans have weaknesses, so as long as you know their weaknesses and you can play into it, honestly, most Titan fights you'll have with Scorch, you'll come out on top. So overall, Scorch is ideal for close to melee engagements, like I said, and can be down. And can down a Titan with a well-placed gas canister, and his flame core, if it lands a direct hit, can wipe a half-health Titan in a mere few seconds. Or even better, it could completely kill the Titan and the pilot in one go if the Titan is doomed. And any other people that's on the ground, any pilots or AI that's on the ground who suffer the flame core wrath, yeah, they're not gonna survive it. You can take out Titans from distances, but I recommend you have cover in front of you, like I said, and practice first while you just get used to landing your shots. Now, if you can learn to practice your shots and land them at specific areas, preferably if you can learn how to land your shots onto the critical area, so the red area that lights up in most time fights, the cockpit. If you can do enough damage on that area there and learn to use Scorch at effective ranges, not only will Scorch feel like to you like he's effective at all types of support, but like I said, facing people like Tone or Legion, they'll be quite easy. And I know a lot of people complain saying they're too OP and such, and yes, they can be OP at times, depending on the player. If you're experienced enough, you can practically make them, you can practically make them worry about themselves, you can practically make them rethink their plan. Sometimes a Tone player will get really cocky and think, well, yeah, I'll take the Scorch player out quite easily, but a well-placed canister and a well-placed shot to the cockpit can make them rethink their plan and think, okay, this situation, I'm not going to win. And I've seen it many times, because Scorch, playing Scorch as my main, is probably the funnest and biggest fun I've ever had with all the Titans. I haven't even used Legion yet, so that's kind of saying something to me. So, lastly, if in any case a Titan is too close, like I said, just use your flame shield to soak up damage and dish out damage, and while you're at it, make sure you backpedal and bait out players into giving traps when you're using gas canisters, as they're quite effective. The whole point of Scorch is that he's meant to suppress an area with a bombardment of fire. What you want to do is act like the other player is overcoming you. So if you can, try and bait them to come to you. And while you're at it, place some traps down. Place a well-placed canister next to a building that you know they're going to come to. Then, when you're at a good distance, use your firewall to ignite it. Hopefully, they would walk into it and they take damage. While you're there, when that happens, then shoot one of your T203 launcher thermite shells to hit them. They will either dash forward or dash backwards, depending on the situation. If they dash forward, you dash back. And you keep doing this until they can't do anything about it. Then, if they try to get too close, use your thermite shield and do even more damage. But just be aware that compared to your thermite shield to Ion's magnetic shield, you don't take up damage and then you can dish it back out again. Like Ion can take certain bullets or rockets and you can fire back at the players or Titans. With you, it's more of whatever, anything that hits your thermal shield will get destroyed. But anyone that gets close to your thermal shield will die. I'm not sure if that works the same way if you go up close to them with a thermite shield, to a pilot, I mean, with the thermite shield and you destroy them. But that's something I should probably test now that I mention it. But like I said, overall, Scorch is good. Honestly, I recommend him. Play around with him. Play on tight maps like Crash Site or Complex. These two maps are really effective when it comes down to AI and players being a cluster, and he pretty much best plays in game modes such as Bounty Hunter. So go ahead, go play around with him, do some of the things I mentioned to you, and then maybe come back and mention how you feel about him. Because honestly, Scorch, a whole team of Scorch players, is quite frightening. So I hope you enjoyed, and I hope to see you again soon, guys.